What's up, guys? Welcome back to the garage. And today's the day Tony's been waiting for. Tony's been waiting for this for a while.
Yeah, guys, my whole life.
So, right here, we basically, what do you have going on? I don't want to ask.
Oh, the camps are going to be pulled back
in. Okay. But, basically, Tune is done, so the Z is getting started today.
Well, not done, the base.
Well, yeah, base. So we still got to go through a couple things. Like, as you can see, I was messing with that. VATS is turned off. And then trans, I had to go through it and switch everything over into manual right there. Don't know if you can see that, but then engine. Had to mess with the idle quite a bit, just the base, rolling idle, move the RPM up. That way we can get some info and that way it doesn't die on us. Airflow, had to mess with a couple things on there. Really kind of leave a lot of this alone because you can dial it in more effectively over here with the proportional and such.
What are we gonna do about the math?
The math, you're going to have to put that on.
There's nowhere to put that on.
Oh, well, looks like we're not running the math and just going off the map. So really hope I got this table dialed in real quick. Let me just look at the, I want to smooth all that out.
All right, cam sensors hooked back in.
So smoothing all that out real quick. Yeah, that looks a lot better. So going through everything, basically. No really dynamic air throw, electronic throttle. He has that hooked up. Exhaust. Yes, recirculation. They already had that disabled.
What?
For the EGR.
Oh, they did?
Yeah. So that's cool. And then over here, just fuel. General, like, 33-pound injectors. Stuff I've really shown you already, but it's just... simple stuff. Simple stuff that takes a little bit of time. So,
yeah, just finishing touches over here, guys.
After Tony gets this done, we're going to get our portable little wideband hooked up, powered up, rednecked.
Dude,
just set it right
him,
there.
I don't know if we showed him that the accessories are finally...
Oh yeah, the accessories are finally on and everything. Yeah, the
and
tension.
We were able to still use power steering.
Yeah, and power steering, but all those lines have to be hooked up. But
yeah.
Hey, we're just trying to get the motor to run right now, and then we'll button everything up. Yeah, so we got the tuner right to the ECM. It was really weird. Tony had to pull the radio fuse because that was causing interference. Wouldn't allow it to erase the old tune.
So you said turn this off.
Yeah, key off, key back on. So Tony's about to go and cycle it up right now. And let me start the scanner. Real quick. Doop 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 doop. This is tons of fun, guys. Alright, whenever you're ready to crank, crank.
You just gotta ground the fuel pump.
Alright. So that's weird. Are you going again?
Yeah.
Come on. Alright, so now it's not wanting to go right now at all. Alright, so we changed the fueling, took a lot of it out. And Tony's about to crank now, so let's see if she goes.
You got one?
Oh, yeah, my bad.
Because that's not on a switch yet.
You still smoke gas? conundrum right now, so we'll see. All right, so little update. I thought we had it all figured out, was going to lean it out a little bit because we were getting too much gas and everything like that. But coming through here, when I pulled the log and everything, I wasn't getting any crank RPM from the scanner. You know why that was, Tony? Tony, why was that? Dude, you gotta tell him.
Someone forgot to hook the Lingen filter box correctly into the cam.
Alright, so basically what that means is with all of this thing, blah, 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 the hard parts on it, this box takes that 24 to 58 reluctor that's on there and converts it into this 24, and that 4-time cam gear that's on there and converts it into a 1-time. And it converts that into it electronically. And who had the cam sensor?
Dude, let's start it real quick.
Connected wrong. So we're gonna see if it starts real quick.
Polarize that fuel pump.
And see how that goes. Yeah, just shout out to Tony's grounding of the fuel pump, because we still have buttoning up to do. And it's still not working. So. Hey, honestly, dude, those plugs are probably super wet.
What?
Those plugs are probably super wet from gas.
Sure,
yeah, so we're gonna just have to let those dry out. So we're gonna let those dry out real quick, and we'll be back at it in a second. We are back on the Z. So that last clip that you saw in this video of it was us having a little couple issues. Tony hooked up a sensor wrong, you know. But after we got that sensor issue fixed, made sure that was all good to go, it did fire. Probably should plug up the power steering real quick, or just attach it fully. But Tony's taking care of the Tony's taking care of the oil cooler plate right now of that little box right there. So he's about to put that plate on. We're gonna get the radiator in too. Are we just gonna fill this with water?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, because we don't have any coolant laying around right now.
And then we'll just dump all fluids.
Huh?
We'll dump all fluids at once it's broken in.
Yeah, now, I mean, that makes sense. So Tony's gonna get the radiator and everything in, and then while he's doing that, because we know that it'll start up on the stock tune, because I thought it was my tuning for a second, but then it just turned out it was a sensor. So I'm gonna throw the tune that I made for this cam in there. Yeah, throw the tune that I made for this cam in there. Tony's got his oil cooler, you know. Ooh, that little Larry. What, $40 on Amazon?
Oh no, this is.
I think
eBay special?
Nah,
it wasn't cheap as $40, but
it's reasonable. Bad. And then all there's the line clamps. Is that line right there?
Yeah, this should be all the big cord line.
Oh boy. That's the big cord line. These already have the ends and everything on them. Yeah. Dude, that
it's
is
all
sweet.
Done up, yeah.
Sweet. So Tony's gonna get that thrown on. Try to get the radiator hooked up, fill it up with water, burp that system out real quick while I get this tune finished up, load that tune on there,
and
make
let me show you what's cool about this.
Make some
oil cooler. Where'd that thing go?
What thing? That plate?
Yeah.
I don't know. You had it.
Oh, goodness, guys.
This yeah, Tony's losing things right now. Losing his mind, losing his parts. But like I said, I just need a load this tune up, get it wrote into it. You like my screensaver?
What
it's a
it?
Kitty cat. No, it's a leopard. It's one of the stock ones. Yeah, here's this plate. Here's his oil pressure gauge right here, you know, just mechanical.
No, it's electronical. Well, mechanical on the inside, then it sends the sensored feed, just like any gauge.
Nice, man. Nice.
But, here's those.
Oh, so and it just then, bolts in. So it's got one.
You need a plug. Yeah.
Yeah, and then this one.
Yeah, and then that one on the side. So you just need that.
But
one.
This is so I can have for turbo. The turbo line.
When you eventually go there.
Yeah.
And it's already restricted down for a feed. So
pretty neat. They're all the same size Allen, even better.
Alright. We've been talking for a second. We're about to get stuff done on this. Alright, Chance the Tuner, back at ya. So I have the 280s like first startup tune that I'm gonna load up in a second. Just want to show you guys some of the other stuff I changed and everything. So if you can see like that green stuff right there, those are stuff that's different because I have a compare tune open right now too. So I have the first startup tune loaded up and then the bass tune just as a compare. So airflow, pretty different because the airflow, the MAF, and the MAP sensor control what fuel. That's just the cranking volumetric efficiency table, and those are just the cylinder charge temperature. What I like about HV tuners is it goes and shows a brief description down here of what it is. Might not be able to see it, might depends on how big of a screen you're talking doing. Really just messed with these a little bit just to make sure, because on that initial startup it was kind of rich, so I just pulled like 3% out. This is really where all the cam stuff is under the engine idle tab. So that's just the base set point, the rolling moving idle. So like if you're in drive and it's down there at the idle RPM, there's the adaptive idle stuff really, and then it's just a lot of different stuff. That's kind of what's good about cams, because it's kind of like injectors. You just plug in everything about that cam, really. So I just plugged in all LS9 stuff through here. Tony's over there making noise, getting the radiator in and such, you know?
Yeah.
But it's pretty basic. I'm not going to say it's basic. It took quite a bit of research and learning about tuning to get to this point. Fuel, did a couple things here. Spark, really the idle spark advance is really the big thing. The only reason why these two are green right now is because the bass tune and the first startup tune are different. And the only reason why those are different is because those just needed to be pulled back a little. Like I just pulled it back by like a degree because I really don't want the whole car to go boom on first startup, you know. Not trying to push tons of horse torques right now. Tony's confused it. Got the radiator. Ooh, that might, yeah, we still need to pull that side of that pipe back a little bit. Get a little bit closer to the motor. Are we gonna do that, or are we just gonna move this in front of this cross member, or what are we planning to do on this? You know? Tony think real good.
So let me go grab those fans, because this can be like, look at this space, this still needs to get pushed up against start.
Yeah.
So yeah, we got about maybe eventually. I don't know if we said that in the video, but I wanted to make some crazy like efficient air dam
bead
system. But for right now, I think it's just stack. Because right now we're not going to be any boost. I'd like to get this bass tune for NA, and then drive it around, get some miles on it, make sure everything that we did is good before we add boost. So for right now, it's just oil cooler, radiator, and drive it. Then when boost comes along, maybe.
Dude, you don't have AC in this beauty.
Anyways, but I got some low pro fans I'll go grab. They are a push or pull system, so if we have to,
mount them on the front.
And that would put them in between the intercooler and the radiator.
Yeah, so that would
force air to come through the intercooler into there while it's out of steady motion.
All right, so Tony's going to go grab those fans from our parts store inside the house. I just showed you guys really the basics on the tune, what's going to be loaded up for this first startup. I mean, it's not crazy radical stuff, just if you're gonna try to tune yourself, do a lot of research. Like, I definitely went for the past 4 or 5 months and have just been learning about tuning. Not an expert. Don't try this at home. This is a risk that you take yourself. Tony understands what he's having me do, but he trusts me, so we're all good. So we're gonna wait for him to come back with those fans and then try to get this radiator mounted up. All right, guys, so we tried a couple times off camera to go and fire it up. Didn't know VATS. I had to write the entire, it's brickable, so it's kind of scary to write the entire computer. But it takes a second.
Yeah, so explain your process, what you had to do.
Honestly, I think I'm going to do a complete other video on that, just so I can go in a little bit more in depth.
Yeah.
And do like a screen recording to show you exactly.
It seems pretty simple, but you'll be able to explain it actually.
Yeah, so I'll go in with a screen recording of this and just voice over everything and show you what's up with that. But other than that, it's riding right now. Still got like 2.5 minutes left on that.
Wait, so I have a P59 in the VATS, is a what?
P01. But this is radiator.
Wait, so on the pipe.
Radiator in, dump pipe.
Yeah, welded up a V-band to it so it can be in the place of the turbo while we
tune this. Yeah, that way I can put my white band in there too.
Drive around with no hood on.
But other than that, it's just waiting for this to go up. The VATS, blah, blah, blah. But we'll be back in a second.
Did you say Rada Rada?
Yeah, I said Rada Rada. Dude, it's our catchphrase now. Rada Rada.
God, what show is that on?
But, no.
50% we done, so we'll be back, I guess.
Yeah, so we'll be back in a second. All right, the tune's right on. I'm about to turn the fuel pump on. Wait a minute, why is the fuel pump not coming on?
Oh, hang on.
All right, Tony has to do wiring real quick. All right, so I turn the fuel pump on, have scanner up.
Key off, and now start it?
Yeah, key off, key on. You just heard her, boys and girls, and I only got a little bit of a scam because it didn't do it, but y'all just heard the 280's first startup. Tony's
hell yeah,
gotta do that. Tony's definitely gonna have some fun tonight, if you know what I mean.
He's gonna do that. Sounded good.
It did. So that wasn't even pulled down in the RPMs. The lowest the RPMs really got that I saw, because I didn't have it long enough. Let me see if I can pull this closer. Come on, little Larry. Oh, well. So, long-term fuel trim, short-term. I mean, it doesn't have O2s on it right now. So, can't really tell what's up with that, but hey, air fuel ratio commanded was at 14.8. why was it doing that? So I might have to keep doing a couple things in this tune, but hey, it sounds good. Has your boy's tune on it, you know. Hit me up for all your tuning needs, you know. I mean, don't, because I'm not a professional tuner. I'm just doing this stuff on the side, you know. It's a side hustle. We know all about them side hustles, don't we, Tony?
Oh, yeah.
But, dude, is that a note that we can end a video on, or what?
Yeah. Yeah. Dude, I'm ecstatic.
Yeah, so.
That sounded healthy.
Dude, and one hitter quitter on the tune. So, I mean, I had a rough idea of what I needed to do. Looked at some other people's tunes that I had available to me. But, guys, so much progress on the Z in just, what, 20 minutes?
Oh, yeah, man. Like,
dude, I am. He is excited. So, I have a little bit of a log to go through. Not that much. Because I didn't have the wideband hooked up to that at all. We just wanted to get it started and idled a little bit, which it did.
Yeah, I was off the pedal.
You were?
And then I gave it some...
Yeah, I know. I saw that a couple times on the scanner. Yeah, definitely
it did. It idled. It sounded sweet, dude.
Yeah.
What's the idle set at?
I don't know. I'll have to go in and relook. I think I upped it a little bit.
It sounded like it was pretty high.
I upped it a little bit just to keep it safe. Because on a new cam startup, you don't want to set it down way too low and then it not start because you set the rev limit way too low. So I might be able to go in there, you know, cut some revs off that idle so it gets some choppy. But hey, that's on me. I just got to clean up the tune a little bit, get a little bit of a log with a wideband in there. The only thing I saw weird in the log was it wasn't commanding a 14:7. Air fuel ratio is commanding like a straight 14, so I'm gonna have to go through that, look into that, get that. I might do like a little bit of like some HP tuner stuff for you guys and some videos. I'm a professional tuner, just gonna say that right now, but just somebody that doesn't have it might want to start learning, you know. I might just show you what HP Tuners looks like, especially if you want to buy the product. I mean, if people are doing LS swaps, I know how to do VATS delete now pretty well. So that might be a couple videos that we come out here pretty soon, just showing you what's up and stuff with that. But hey, you got any other words?
Nope. I am.
You don't look happy. Get excited.
But I want you to get a good record off this thing.
Oh,
to get the
boy.
People on there first start.
All right. Well, Tony wants to do things for the gram, so I guess we're about to be out, guys. Thanks for watching this video. Thanks for sticking with us with the 280Z project. It means a lot.
Now
especially,
we can move on to wiring and get it all wrapped up and get a drive shaft made and get some brakes put on and go rip around.
We're going to do tandem burnouts. It's going to be
and
fun.
And then wreck them both into each other. And then we'll be back at square one.
Dude, we got to keep providing content for the channel. But, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you liked that video. If I haven't said it already in this video, because we bounced around a couple days on this one, hit that subscribe button. Hit that thumbs up. And we'll see you back here pretty soon with more content.